Hi, my name is Mahek. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to master advanced level skills in cinemagraph creation and editing in Flixel Cinemagraph Pro for iOS. If this is the first time that you are using the app, I would recommend that you take a look at the Getting Started tutorial, where you will learn about the entire cinemagraph creation process. Or, if you are just starting to dig deeper into the app, check out the intermediate tutorial, where you will learn about precise editing skills in masking, looping, and color adjustments. But if you're comfortable with the app and familiar with the different types of editing options, you're probably ready to advance your skills to the highest level. So, let's dive in. We are going to create a cinemagraph that relies just as much on the production process as it does on the editing process. Creating a cinemagraph that involves isolating a movement on a subject that is supposed to stay still is often quite challenging because the subject must stay still at the exact same time. For this cinemagraph, I filmed Cassandra stirring the milk in her tea using my iPhone on a tripod. In order to capture a motion that will loop seamlessly, Cassandra needs to be completely still while maintaining a consistent stir with her right hand. Her hand can move, but it has to be the same motion over and over and over again. Here are two tips that you can use to create a shot like this for your cinemagraph. Firstly, film multiple takes so that you have options. Secondly, ensure that there is a clean line of separation between the limb in motion and the rest of the body. In this shot, you can see the separation at Cassandra's wrist. After a few takes, we can go ahead and start editing our cinemagraph in Flixel Cinemagraph Pro for iOS. Select both the video and still image by moving the trimmer and the still image selector, respectively. If you want to perfect your repeat loop, you need to consider the in and out points of the video footage that you've selected for your cinemagraph. I selected a point that occurs right before Cassandra finishes her clockwise stir as my out point. Achieve the perfect loop by selecting an out point that appears just before your in point. Next, you're going to mask using the brush tool. Start by masking with a smaller brush size and a lower hardness in the entire area that you want to mask. Mask Cassandra's hand stirring, then blend it all the way into the sleeve of her shirt. Here's an editing tip. Zoom into your cinemagraph to ensure that you are editing as precisely as possible. To zoom in, use two fingers and pinch outwards. If we stopped here, we wouldn't achieve the seamless blend that we want. Adjust the eraser tool with a low hardness and half opacity to blend the edges together. To see how your editing fits in with the rest of your cinemagraph, simply pinch inwards with two fingers. Tap on Loop under the Timeline tab. Since you are creating a cinemagraph that contains an illusion of continuous stirring, we are going to use the repeat loop. Adjust the crossfade slightly to create your seamless motion. Awesome! Check out that perfect loop. Swipe in the Timeline tab and tap on Still Image. If you want to add text or edit your selected still image, you can export it to an external photo editing app, modify it, and import it back. Just remember that if you make changes to the color and tone of the still image, it will no longer match the video you shot for your cinemagraph. You're probably already aware of the presets available to you, but we get it. To make your cinemagraph truly your own, you can edit your cinemagraph exactly how you would like to using the color correcting, light, and tone curve elements under the Adjustments tab. The tone curve adjustments are particularly helpful as they allow you to make in-depth adjustments to your cinemagraphs. You can make adjustments to the blacks, shadows, highlights, and whites while the RGB tab is selected, which will modify the look of your entire cinemagraph. When you select the red tab, you can focus on changing the individual elements in your cinemagraph. The same is applicable to the green and blue color tabs. I want to create a cinemagraph with a slightly cooler feel, so I'm going to go ahead and take the red out of the blacks. I am happy with these settings, but I recommend that you continue to experiment with these features to create a look that is one of a kind. Wow, you just created a cinemagraph worthy of some of our top creators, so let's make sure it gets shared. Export your Cinemagraph and select the repetitions. You can even select the number of repetitions based on the network you're sharing it on, so that your Cinemagraph video file is optimized for that particular social media network. You can then save it to your library or Creative Cloud, or share it instantly to social media from the app. Make sure to upload your work to your Flixel gallery, where your Cinemagraphs will live infinitely and beautifully. We love to see and feature Cinemagraphs created by our fantastic community across all of our social media platforms. To find more inspiration on how to achieve your Cinemagraph goals, check out our curated galleries on Flixel.com and all of the tips, tricks, and news that we share on our social media channels. We are constantly creating new resources to help you along your Cinemagraph journey. We love profiling creators, sharing brand stories, and featuring work from our community. We can't wait to see what you bring to life in your next Cinemagraph. Make sure to keep in touch. We'll see you soon.